today's video, we'll be looking at the long-range strike bomber LRS-B program and the new B-21 bomber aircraft. By the end of the decade, the Northrop Grumman B-21 radar heavy bomber should be in service. It is being developed as part of the long-range strike bomber LRS-B program and will be the most advanced long-range heavy payload stealth aircraft ever to fly. It will be able to carry nuclear as well as conventional weapons. Stay till the end of the video to see what these new bombers are capable of. The long-range strike bomber LRS-B is a development and procurement program for the United States Air Force to build a long-range strategic bomber with a massive payload capable of delivering thermonuclear weapons. In July of 2014, a call for proposal to create the aircraft was posted. The Air Force intends to purchase at least 100 LRS-B aircraft for a total cost of $550 million each, with up to 200 units potentially entering service in the future. In October 2015, Northrop Grumman was given a development contract for its B-21 Raider. Because of the project's sensitive nature, much of it is classified, and only limited information is available to the public. As of late 2019, it was known that the aircraft's construction had begun. General Norton Schwartz, the Air Force Chief of Staff, stated on May 19, 2009, that the United States Air Force's 2010 budget would be focused on long-range strike and not next-generation bombers, and that he would push for this in the Quadrennial Defense Review. The two teams working on next-generation bomber concepts were then asked to stop in June 2009. Secretary of Defense Robert Gates approved the concept of a new bomber on September 16, 2009, but stressed that it be expensive, saying, "We must not repeat the mistakes made with our last manned bomber." Despite its considerable capabilities, the aircraft turned out to be so expensive, at $2 billion each in the case of the B-2 Spirit, that only about 1/6 of the anticipated fleet of 132 was actually produced by the time the research, development, and requirements procedures were completed. On October 5, 2009, Undersecretary of Defense for Acquisition Ashton Carter stated that the Department of Defense was still debating whether the United States Air Forces required a new bomber, and that if authorized, the plane would have to be capable of both surveillance and strike missions. Carter stated in July 2010 that affordability will be a criterion for the next generation intelligence and strike platform. On December 11, 2009, Gates stated that the Quadrennial Defense Review had demonstrated the necessity for both manned and unmanned long-range strike, and that financing for the future bomber would most certainly be included in the 2011 budget. The new bomber will be multi-role, having intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance ISR capabilities, according to the U.S. Air Force. The LRS-B will be administered by Air Combat Command's 25th Air Force as a bomber, while ISR assets will be managed by Air Force Global Strike Command. In 2010, Andrew Krepinovich, director of the Center for Strategic and Budgetary Assessments, questioned the use of short-range aircraft like the F-35 to handle China in a future conflict, and advocated for reducing the F-35 purchase in favor of a longer-range platform like the next-generation bomber. The then Air Force Secretary Michael Wynn had rejected this plan in 2007. Then several senators highlighted the LRS-B as a rationale to oppose or delay ratification of the New START treaty during debate in December 2010. Then the United States Air Forces chose to buy 80 to 100 planes in March 2011. One requirement for the bomber, according to the Air Force Global Strike Command, is that it carry a weapon with a similar effect to the Massive Ordnance Penetrator. In addition to the conventional bomber roles of strategic bombing, tactical bombing, and immediate global strike, the aircraft will be part of a family of ground surveillance and electronic attack systems. In its 2012 budget request, the Obama administration requested $197 million over 5 years for the bomber's development, which would include modular payloads for intelligence, surveillance, reconnaissance, ISR, electronic attack, EA, and communications, It will be nuclear capable, but not until older bombers are scheduled to retire before certification. The United States Air Force announced in July 2016 that it will not publicize the projected cost of the B-21 contract with Northrop Grumman, claiming that doing so would reveal too much information about the classified project to prospective adversaries. Over the protest of a bipartisan group of legislators, led by the committee's chairman, Senator John McCain of Arizona, the United States Senate Committee on Armed Services agreed to not publicly divulge the program's cost, confining the information to legislative defense committees. Senator McCain's proposed changes to the National Defense Authorization Act for FY2017 would have cut funding for the B-21 program by $302 million due to a lower-than-expected contract award value, while also requiring strict program baseline and cost control thresholds, quarterly program performance reports, and disclosure of the engineering and manufacturing development total contract award value. The B-21 was officially named Raider on September 19, 2016, in honor of the Doolittle Raiders at the naming ceremony at the Air Force Association Conference. Retired Lieutenant Colonel Richard E. Cole, the last survivor of the Doolittle Raiders, was present. The B-21 was built around three distinct capabilities: a large and flexible payload bay capable of carrying a full range of current and future armament range, though classified, and a projected average procurement unit cost of $550 million per plane, which was made public to encourage competing manufacturers to limit their designs. We still don't know how many aircraft the USAF will receive during the EMD phase of the program, which is a validation period before full-rate production. But this is the most information on this aspect of the program that has been revealed to yet. The Air Force expects to receive about 150 of the new stealth bombers over the next few years. Overall, the program is said to be on budget and near to being completed on time. During a similar phase of the B-2 Advanced Technology Bomber Program, six planes were completed, and these planes made up the majority of the fleet of 21 that was eventually built. Additional ground test pieces were also included. The B-21 program's details have been notoriously scarce, and there has been some misunderstanding as to the exact state of the aircraft on the assembly line at times. Meanwhile, the countdown to the first flight of the B-21 is well underway, albeit the scheduled date has been pushed back from December of last year, with the aircraft now slated to be delivered sometime in 2022. According to officials, if that time frame is followed, the first Raider will most likely fly in the late spring or early summer of next year. As anticipation rises, the Air Force has only provided a few nuggets that give an indication of how the B-21 will look. However, they too have been cryptic. Most recently, a rendering released in July last year revealed a previously unseen and unusual looking cockpit widescreen layout. Furthermore, there is no certainty that the final product will look exactly like the few renderings we've seen thus far. Before we get into the roles of the B-21, be sure to subscribe to more content like this. According to Randall Walden, director of the Air Force Rapid Capabilities Office, the new stealth bomber is critical to the Pentagon's nuclear modernization program, which is a high priority for the Department of Defense and the Air Force. The B-21 will, of course, be more than a bomber. It will eventually be a multi-role strike and intelligence surveillance and reconnaissance ISR platform that may be manned or unmanned and will be part of a family of advanced systems that will enable and be enabled by other platforms, except for the fact that it will be a high-flying design with roots in the early development of the B-2 that will have broadband low observability next-generation stealth technology, and that will be smaller than its B-2 predecessor. Little is known about it. One thing that is clear is that it will rely on a number of mature subsystems and sensors that are either in production or have undergone extensive risk reduction work. Overall, it will be far more adaptive and flexible than the B-2. Let us know if you think the B-21 bomber aircraft will be revealed. Be sure to check out our video on the deadliest artillery system of the Russia.